Welcome to Read Ancient Languages. I'm Dr. Fausto Labruto. Today, our ancient languages time machine brings us to the city of Rome in Italy, where this magnificent building stands. The name of this building is Pantheon, and it has a very interesting history which spans over 2,000 years. Every year, millions of tourists visit this site. However, I don't think that the majority of them pays attention to the inscription which is visible on its facade. The inscription is in Latin, however, I think that even a person with a solid knowledge of the Latin language will struggle at deciphering it. The reason for this is that inscriptions on walls or monuments, which we normally refer to as epigraphs, often contain abbreviations and symbols which are not common in other types of literature. Today, I will unpack this writing for you. This is a zoomed in image of the inscription, and you can recognize words and single letters separated by dots. On the left hand side, we see the letter M. This letter stands for the name Marcus. Then we see the name Agrippa. Then the letters L and F, which stand for Luci Filius, which means son of Lucius. Then there are the three letters C, O, and S. This is an abbreviation, or rather a contraction, for the Latin word consul. The consul was the main political post in Republican Rome. Then we have the word tertium. Notice how in the Latin alphabet the letters V and U are identical. Tertium means third. Then we have the word fecit, which is the third person singular of the perfect tense indicative of the verb facere, which means to make. Therefore, we have a name, Marcus Agrippa. We have a reference to the person whose this Marcus Agrippa was son of. And then we have an indication that this was made during his third post as consul of Rome. So the sentence reads, Marcus Agrippa, son of Lucius, made this building, during his third post as consul. This is a typical inscription which is a tribute to the person under whose political authority this building was erected. Thank you for following Read Ancient Languages. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Instagram for updates.